Hi, I'm Don Simpson with AWS.
Hi, I'm Praveen Murugan from Hyphen, and this is my architecture.
So Praveen, tell us about Hyphen and the architecture.
Hyphen was established in 2021 as a pair-agnostic platform with a mission to redefine the way the healthcare ecosystem collaborates. Our mission is to make sure that all the parties of the healthcare ecosystem are able to share data and seamlessly collaborate to make healthcare easier for consumers and providers.
So we have the pharmacists and the payers. Why don't you tell us about the architecture, starting with the pharmacists?
Yeah. So the pharmacists typically use a pharmacy management system, and the Hyphen Pharmacy Assistant app is embedded right inside of the pharmacy management system.
Okay.
There are three main interactions that happen from the pharmacy management system. The first one is to authenticate the system for which we use Cognito.
Okay.
The second one is a call where they actually make a check for alerts. This is where the pharmacy assistant app notifies them if there are events that they need to act on.
Okay.
And the last one is to actually launch the UI, which has all the data that they need.
Okay. And the type of alerts for a pharmacist, take action, next step?
Yeah. So the type of actions that they're typically displayed to the pharmacist are the actions that they would want to do for the patient.
Okay.
Things like, hey, you have a 30-day refill. Would you want to convert it into a 90-day refill? Do you want to synchronize all your medications? So there are activities like that, okay, which are provided to the pharmacist so they can take an action.
Okay. So based on this interaction, is it fair to say that the application, what you've embedded, is what you're authenticating and authorizing here?
That is right.
And the reason why you're putting it in the application is for like friction or latency? What is the...
Yeah. So one of the reasons we had an option to build this standalone or to actually do the extra effort to embed this right into their existing workflow.
Okay.
It was very important for us to embed it right into their workflow because we did not want to have them deviate, because pharmacists are typically filling hundreds and hundreds of scripts.
Right.
For them to go to a completely different app to take this action is just going to be more friction for them.
Okay.
So that was the key consideration for us to embed it right into their existing
workflow.
Now
that makes a lot of sense. So as we move over to the right here, so MemoryDB, I'm assuming it's related to that latency. Can you talk about trade-offs and selection here?
Yes. So once, as part of the launch, when we're actually trying to pull the data back,
mm-hmm,
that's when our services are actually going and fetching the data from MemoryDB.
Okay.
And MemoryDB, one of the main reasons we picked it was for latency and for data isolation.
Okay.
This product right now is actually used by Health First,
mm-hmm,
but the goal is to actually make sure that any payers out there can actually also use the product.
Okay.
So for us to make sure that the data is isolated in its own cluster was one important factor. The second thing was the super low latency. We ensured that all end-to-end interaction, all the way from the pharmacist to our app, had to be about 80 to 100 milliseconds.
Okay.
And MemoryDB was how we got that.
And were you able to achieve that just with MemoryDB, or did you have to make other modifications to your app?
Good question. So most of the calls were actually coming from MemoryDB, but there were some checks where there was some data that was actually needed even on the edge.
Mm-hmm.
And that was where we had some data actually available in the edge on our services to keep the latency even lower.
Okay.
So some of those calls, mm-hmm, we were able to get it to a 40 to 50 milliseconds by keeping some lookup data right on the edge.
Okay, now that makes a lot of sense. So I understand the pharmacist, but how does the payer and its data get into the system?
Yeah, so the way we built the data streaming from payers,
mm-hmm,
was to make a service available for them to stream the data to us.
Okay.
Getting data real time into our platform was very important, because that ensured that the data was available real time to display back to the pharmacist. So we made sure that the payers are able to stream the data, mm-hmm, to MSK, and then a consumer was actually listening to the topic from,
okay,
MSK and hydrating the data into Redis.
Why did you select MSK instead of, you know, maybe running your own, hosting your own?
Yeah. MSK is actually core to everything we do in,
mm-hmm,
Hyphen. We build all our architecture with events across the board. Going with MSK provided us the ability to go to market faster,
mm-hmm,
without losing any of the functionality that we would get from Kafka.
Okay. All right, so we have Aurora and QuickSight. Can you walk me through how they are part of this flow in your,
yes,
architecture?
Yes. Going back to how we have an event-based architecture, all services that we have in Hyphen are constantly emitting events to MSK.
Okay.
Once these events make it to MSK, we actually stream most of the data mm-hmm. into Aurora, where we need to capture all the analytical data. Once the data gets into Aurora, we have real-time dashboards that are actually listening to that data or fetching the data from Aurora
okay.
and making those dashboards available for payers. The payers use these dashboards to see how the program is performing,
right.
how the pharmacies are performing, how many members are adherent, how many members they've converted. So it provides a lot of very meaningful insights back to the payers to see how the whole product right. works.
And then also Aurora, any trade-offs or decisioning there for you?
Again, it was the option which we actually went with the managed services. We wanted to make sure that the data was available in Aurora for mm-hmm. us to, in a relational database for it to then be made available in QuickSight.
And then just overall, the benefits of this architecture are?
So the most important thing that I would say is the low latency mm-hmm. Part of it. With MemoryDB, we were able to really bring down the latency of the data being served up to the pharmacist. Mm-hmm. Keeping it to the 50 to the 80 millisecond overall was very important because mm-hmm. these pharmacists are tabbing through their system and they're able to quickly complete the actions that are relevant for this product and then move on to whatever they're actually going to do. So the low latency and what MemoryDB gives us that mm-hmm. is one of the most important thing. The second thing is MSK, event-based architecture across the board, and making sure that we are streaming all our events through MSK was the second important thing. And EKS was the last one for us to be able to scale horizontally as we increase the number of pharmacies that use the product and also bringing on more payers in the future.
Right, well, that seems to be very important to the extensibility for pharmacists as payers. So really appreciate you sharing your architecture, Praveen.
Thank you. Thank you.